last year. And I am with Alfredo Parisi, part of the Libre Umbria's working group. Who is Libretalia? The first question. Libretalia is a voluntary Italian association founded by the Italian community of LibreOffice, which arose from Libretalia's Google Plus community. Libretalia is made up of developers, trainers, teachers, ICT professionals, civil servants, but also domestic users, ordinary users, who wants to share solutions and problems about LibreOffice and about open source in general, and about also by open data and open government. The 23 founders are ICT professionals and civil servants with a valuable experience of migration. Valuable experience of migration from Microsoft Office to LibreOffice. And many of the founders are members of the Document Foundation and therefore already actively engaged in the LibreOffice project. Almost all of the members of the Board of Directors of Libretalia are present here in Berlin at the LibreOffice conference. Marina Latini, our Vice President and Technical Manager. Alfredo Parisi, who spoke about the Libre project, and our honorary president, Italo Vignoli. The other members of the board who can't be with us today are Andrea Castellani, Giordano Borghetti, and Gabriele Ponzo. Libretalia's community on Google Plus has almost 2,400 active members that every day share news, information, problems and solutions about LibreOffice and about open source in general. The community is very important for professional and domestic users who are looking for solutions to specific problems. And many members of the community follow discussions and quickly provide responses to the requests for help from users. In addition, the community also provides an important meeting point for people to build new professional networks. Libretalia is also very social. We have a Twitter account, a Facebook page, and more recently a YouTube channel and a SlideShare profile that help us to introduce our activities and our project. Our blog, LibreItalia.it, plays an important communication role. In the blog, we publish every week news about the LibreOffice project, but also documents, spreadsheets, presentations, models developed by the members of the community who want to share their work with others. For example, last month we published a spreadsheet with a budget template developed by a member of the LibreItalia community. We also publish interviews with ICT professionals who, in business or in public administrations, have ended the migration from Microsoft Office to LibreOffice in order to provide success stories to emulate. And finally, in the blog, we publish news about events organized by our community and by other open source community in Italy. And OK. Okay, and the question what we have done? We have a wealth of valuable experiences at LibreItalia. The first one, Libre Umbria, Libre Umbria, the migration project of Umbria's regional government administration that has involved about 5,000 desktops and similar projects in the provinces of Bolzano, Macerata, Cremona, and Milan, and in the municipalities of Terni, Viterbo, and Turin, more recently in Turin. Another significant project has involved the desktops of one of Italy's major trade of union, CISL. And another important project is Libre Veneto. Libre Veneto deals with the regional public health organization, where about 500 desktops have been migrated, and another 1,000 are planned for the next year. The total number of workstations migrated so far in Italy is about 16,000. LibreItalia wants to support the digital culture and the culture of free and open source software through seminars, courses, and training sessions. For example, in August, we organized, in association with the Umbrian Linux User Group, the Linux Summer. The event consists of 5 free access seminars on Linux and LibreOffice and open source internet browsers and email software. And LibreItalia wants to spread the best practice of migration through national contests. For example, the national contest organized by Formans in Italy and aimed at the individualization of experience, which formed the national guidelines for digital culture and skills, which now contains LibreUmbria's model of teaching in public administration. And what we will do: promote LibreOffice and open source, obviously. LibreItalia wishes to facilitate the development, dissemination, and promotion of the LibreOffice suite and the open source software to reduce the digital divide and to break down the barriers of information and technology for the people who are less able to access opportunities. Develop digital culture and skills. LibreItalia wants to promote digital culture to provide all citizens equal access to technology and equal opportunities of participation to the knowledge society. And spread free software in public administrations and schools. LibreItalia will contribute to spreading open source software in public administration, especially in schools and universities, to support the growth of digital culture and the value of collaboration by young people. Promote open document format. LibreItalia will promote the spreading of open formats, like Open Document Format, ODF, to allow the interoperability and therefore to guarantee permanent access to the data and information, especially in public administration. Support open data usage. We wish to promote the dissemination of open data and free and universal access to resources and information. We think that the monopoly of ideas is to limit the cultural development of everyone. Encourage digital new enterprises. LibreItalia wants to encourage the birth of new enterprises enterprises who can develop new solutions for open source software and provide job opportunities for young people. What we'd like to organize? We'd like to organize courses also in e-learning for LibreOffice developers in order to increase the number of ICT professionals in the Italian community and therefore in the LibreOffice project. An Italian conference. In the coming months we will organize the first Italian LibreOffice conference in order to promote the activities and the project of LibreItalia. Support ECDL open source. We'll create a working group who will support the development and dissemination of European computer driving license with open source software, in particular with LibreOffice. And developing an e-learning platform for LibreOffice courses. LibreItalia wishes to develop an e-learning platform to put free LibreOffice courses online. We should complete and grow the prototype of Libre Umbria's project named Libre Campus and realize in recent months with Moodle and WordPress. How we get organized? LibreItalia wants to constitute a committee of experts in open government and open source that will help us to identify the project and the activities of the association. And we will create some working groups with a team leader who can coordinate the work of the volunteers. And the members of LibreItalia will keep in touch by video conference and also by meetings in different Italian cities. We think in October we will organize the first meeting in the city of Perugia, in the center of Italy. The answer when after 3 years of living as an online community, LibreItalia was born in August as an organization. In August this year, and the necessary paperwork for recognition as a non-profit organization has just been submitted, but our founders began to define our goals and activities sometime before that. We are organizing a lot of things in the next few months, and most of which I've already mentioned in this presentation, and I tell you, follow us if you want. Where are we? LibreItalia's headquarters are in the city of Perugia, in the center of Italy. The choice of location is linked to the Libre Umbria project, which gave a boost to many of the activities that we intend to organize as an association. But apart from this, Perugia is geographically at the center of the Italy, so easy to reach for those who live in the north than in the south. And the last question, why LibreItalia? The first reason is for free software in public administration. The spread of open source software in Italy, in public administration, is patchy. There are some best practices to follow, like LibreUmbria, Veneto, but there is still much to do, especially in public administration, where it is necessary to present the opportunities of the open source software, where it is too often unknown. LibreItalia has calculated that the Italian public administration could gain 600 million euro adopting LibreOffice. And we all know that this is not the only reason why public administrations should choose open source software. Free software in schools. LibreItalia can support initiatives aimed to increase the use of open source software in schools and in the universities, as shown the Libre Umbria School project. Most schools have only experienced proprietary software. With the Libre Umbria School project, we organized seminars aimed to teachers and parents to educate them on how technological choices impact the sharing of knowledge. We also provide courses that show how schools how to switch the PCs in open source software. Free software to support digital culture. In Italy, according to a recent European Commission research, 60% of Italians don't have digital skills necessary to do their jobs. And it's no better for our digital natives, who, according to UKids Online Research, are second last for digital skills. The adoption of free software, according to the model that we will propose, that focuses on training, develops skills, and goes to fill many of the gaps which people have. Open format in public administration. The Microsoft proprietary format doc, unfortunately, is considered the standard for many public administrations. If we consider the value of information and data, we understand that this is an absurdity. So LibreItalia wants to support the spread of open formats like ODF and apply pressure so that they can be adopted by all the Italian public administrations, as has already happened in the UK. All the activities that we will do will focus on the growth of the Italian community and therefore the LibreOffice project. Here there are our contacts. You can contact us by email, or you can follow us on social media, on Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus, and Slash Share, and Flickr. You can read and follow our blog, LibreItalia.it. And thank you. Thanks to Italo Mignoli. LibreItalia owes its success to him.
That's not true. They have been well paid.
Thanks for your attention, and thanks to the organizers of LibreOffice Conference for hosting us today. Thank you very much.
I'm here to answer questions, but luckily everyone in the project knows me, so know how.
One. How many of the migrations or the administrations have support, professional support for LibreOffice? Do all of them have it, or some? You know,
public administration and some public administrations have ended the migration in-house.
Yes.
But many public administrations don't have the professionals in-house to do the migration, and so they need the help from enterprise, from business enterprise.
And is it also support for bug fixing sometimes, or just for the migration process itself?
It's more a general process. The bug fixing needs education, so people they don't understand that. They're, let's say, in this sense, they are uneducated by Microsoft. The fact that if you find a bug in Microsoft Office, there's no chance to get the bug solved. So they don't even think that they can get the bug solved in LibreOffice. So now we are at the stage that we are educating people and tell people it's important that you find the bug, because if you find the bug, someone can put attention on the bug. And if the bug is really nasty for you, you can pay someone that solves the bug.
Yeah.
But it's yet, you know, people look
people
at you.
Like
yeah, people look at you and say, "But are you serious about that?" I say, "Yes, I'm serious. The code is there, so you can solve the problem."
Yeah.
But then the software is going to work. Yes, of course, it's going to work.
Okay.
The
yeah. When there are good certified migration. People in Italy, all the deployments in the end will understand.
You know, the process is a long one. It's not happening tomorrow. Unfortunately, it's not happening tomorrow.
No, it's not our time.
I didn't catch the amount of money you say in public administration. 600 million.
So it's a projection. So they in the Umbria project, they've analyzed in a very deep way the savings on the first 1,000 users. So they're really, there is a spreadsheet which is in Italian but it's published. So it's you can look at all the costs that have been involved in migrating to LibreOffice compared to all the costs that would have been involved in updating to Microsoft Office. So on the first 1,000 users, they saved 220,000 euros. So if you project the number of employees of the public administration in Italy, which is almost 4 million, if you project those 200,000, it becomes 600 million. This is pure marketing and was my idea, but you have to do that. Otherwise, if you say we save $200,000, people would tell you it's peanuts. So if we say 600 million,
okay, so
then it's. But we have, you know, my idea is if we could say we save 6 billion. I would have told 6 billion. Because you have to give figures that people, that they mind blowing, you know, otherwise no one is going to listen to you.
Anyway, at least you can sell 6,000 desktops, right? 6,000
yes.
Desktops? Times
yeah, exactly.
One Microsoft license, at least.
Yeah, but the reality, their analysis is very complete because they've put all the costs.
Okay.
So training costs, even they've put on the cost of migrating to LibreOffice, even the press conference, which is not a migration cost, just because knowing our chickens, which are Microsoft guys in this case. If you put everything in the spreadsheet, then they cannot tell as they usually do. You know, is because you've not considered everything that then your calculation is more positive than the other. So we have considered everything, even the time that people was going to smoke cigarettes outside, everything was there.
Even the cost of the ICT professionals in-house where the migration...
So it's a really fair comparison. And what is amazing is that it has been presented to a general public administration body with Microsoft guys present, and the Microsoft guy who said could not comment the spreadsheet.
Okay, may I have more questions about the
dashboard? It's so curious. No. I think it's important because it's a data that everyone actually. I have the spread, a summary of the spreadsheet in English. So if people is interested, because that is official. So it's in an official document of the one Italian public administration has been registered. So it's a document that cannot be changed.
It's published on the blog of the
exactly. But you know, it is as a protocol has been recognized. Politicians have acknowledged that. So it's not something that you know I've just got it because I have a friend there. It's an official document. So, and of course you have to reference to the Italian original because that is the only, the English one is just a translation, but it's not the original document, but it's just a translation of an Italian original. And I think that this is important because it gives a reference that no one can discuss. I mean, if you start discussing this, it's really, you know, you're going really after the smoke. Because that is really considering everything.
Okay. Free software support is the culture. Which type of software?
Or in general, open source. The browser is Mozilla, Email, Thunderbird. So we GIMP for.
Nothing special like to preserve buildings.
No, it's really basics. So it's digital. When you have to teach the digital culture, unfortunately, you have to go to the basics. People, it's really, they lack culture, unfortunately. This is the reality.
Okay, and one more. These courses for teachers and parents, they were free of charge or they free of charge? Yes. Free of charge.
Yeah, it doesn't mean that we, as an association, like TDF, we cannot charge for anything. Of course, it depends from the size of the project. If the project is too big, we might ask that the organization pay some money to the professional giving the courses, of course.
Okay, I'm asking because we have Well, in part, we did something similar, and we were told that if it's free of charge, it has no value. But you pay €5, but you have to do something, otherwise, free of charge has no value.
It depends from the environment. It depends from the environment. It actually. In their case, the courses were free of charge, but they were sponsored by the region, so that makes them official in a sense. Of course, it depends from the mentality of people. There are many variables, of course.